ശ്രീ ഗുരുഭ്യോ നമ. നമസ്കാരം ടു ഓൾ ഓഫ് യു. ഐ എം ഡോക്ടർ രാജശ്രീ. ഇൻ ദ പ്രീവിയസ് ക്ലാസ് വി ഹാവ് ഡിസ്കസ്ഡ് ദി സ്ഥാനാസ് ഓഫ് ത്രീ ദോഷാസ് ബേസ്ഡ് ഓൺ ദേശ ആൻഡ് കാല. നൗ വി ആർ ഗോയിങ് ടു ഡിസ്കസ് അബൌട്ട് ദി ക്ലാസിഫിക്കേഷൻ ഓഫ് അഗ്നി ആൻഡ് കോഷ്ഠ അക്കോർഡിംഗ് ടു ത്രീ ദോഷാസ്. വി ക്യാൻ ഗോ ത്രൂ ശാസ്ത്രഭാഗം. തൈർഭവേദ് വിഷമസ്തീക്ഷ്ണോ മന്ദശ്ചാഗ്നി സമൈ സമ കോഷ്ഠക്രൂരോ മൃദുർമധ്യോ മധ്യസ്യാത്തൈ സമൈരപി തൈഹി അഗ്നി വിഷമ തീക്ഷ്ണ മന്ദ ച സമൈഹി സമ ഭവേ തൈഹി കോഷ്ഠ ക്രൂര മൃദു മധ്യ സ്യാത് സമൈഹി അപി മധ്യ. ഐ റിപ്പീറ്റ്, തൈഹി അഗ്നി വിഷമ തീക്ഷ്ണ മന്ദ ച സമൈഹി സമ ഭവേ തൈഹി കോഷ്ഠ ക്രൂര മൃദു മധ്യ സ്യാത് സമൈഹി അപി മധ്യ. Agni and Koshtha are the two important topics in Ayurveda Tantra. Agni denotes the digestive capacity and Koshtha denotes the eliminative capacity. Here, both are classified based on three doshas. First, we will see about the Agni. Agni means Jadhara Agni or Pajaka Pitta itself. Based on the dosha dominance, the character of Agni or the digestive power will change. This is purely based on Prakriti. Agni can be classified into four basically. Vishama, Tikshna, Manda and Sama. This is due to the dominance of Vada, Pitta, Kapha and Sama dosha respectively. Now we can go through each of them. Vadotkarshena Vishama, Aniyata Bhage Vishama. Due to the predominance of Vata dosha, Agni become Vishama. Aniyata Bhaga, that means the digestive capacity is uncertain in nature. This is due to Vata. Next is Tikshna Agni. Pitta Utkarshena Tikshna. Agni become Tikshna due to Pitta dosha. Ashubhage Tikshna, where the digestive capacity is very high and quickly digestion takes place in Pitta dominant persons. Next is Manda Agni. Kabhotkarshena Manda. Due to the Kabha dosha dominance, Agni will become Manda. That is, the digestive capacity is very less in whom Kabha is dominant. Next is Sama Agni. Sama dosha. That is, balanced condition of these three doshas causes Sama Agni. Hani Utkarsha Vivarji Dehi Sama. The digestive power is in a balanced state, not increased or decreased. Such Agni is called as Samagni. In Ashtanga Sangraha Indu Tika, the Dvandva of three doshas are mentioned. In Vadakapha dominance, the Agni will be Mandatva Utkarsha. Mandatva will be more in such condition. And in Pitta Kapha dominance, based on Ahara, sometimes Agni become Tikshna and sometimes it become Manda. This happens both in Prakriti and Vikriti. In Ashtanga Sangraha Sutra 11th chapter, the different types of Agni is classified based on the time period of digestion. Yamehi Chadurbhir Dwabhyam Cha Bhojya Bhaishajyayo Same Pagognav Yuktayo Draktu Tikshne Mande Punachirad. If Ahara digests within 4 yama, 1 yama is equal to 3 hours. Here 4 yama means 12 hours. And Aushadha or medicine digests in 2 yama or 6 hours. The Agni is called as Samagni. In the case of Tikshna Agni, digestion will be drag or faster than Sama. And in the case of Manda Agni, the digestion will be Chira. And it is slower than the Sama. Considering this Agni Bala, we have to take food and Vaidya should prescribe medicine accordingly. This Agni concept is very unique concept of Ayurveda. No other systems of medicine have this. This is purely an individualized concept. Next comes Koshtha. Koshtha denotes the bowel movements. It's classified according to three doshas. It can be classified into four. Koshta kruro mrudur madhyo madhyasyate samirapi. Vadotkarshena krura. If vada is dominant, it's krura koshta. Pittotkarshena mrudu. If pitta is dominant, koshta will be mrudu. Kaphotkarshena madhya. If kabha is dominant, koshta will be madhya koshta. Samehi hanyutkarsha vivarjidehi madhya. If dosha is in a sama avastha, then also the koshta will be madhya koshta. But there is slight difference between kabha adhiga madhya koshta and sama dosha madhya koshta. Shleshmadhige madhyakoshte na samyak virejitvam. Samagabhedu madhyakoshte suvirejitvam. In kabhadhikya, bowel movements will not be perfect as samadosha koshta. In samadosha, the bowel movements will be very perfect in nature. Based on the use of madhyama shodhana dravya, koshta classified by Sushruta. Madhyamena shodhanena heena yogi krura. If we use a drug with moderate virya and the bowel movements are very less, they are called as krura koshta. Madhyamena shodhanena adi yogi mrudu koshta. If bowel movements are increased due to madhyama shodhana dravya, they are called as mrudu koshta. Madhyamena shodhanena samashodhana happens in madhya koshta. If the bowel movements are according to the virya of drug itself, it is called as madhya koshta. If the dosha is in a balanced condition, then also koshta will be madhya itself. Digestion and elimination are the two basic functions of our body, which are under the control of three doshas itself. So, these functions will help us to interpret the prakriti of a person in the chikilsa aspect also. That is, it will help us to select both the food and medicine suitable for an individual. Now, I am concluding this session. We will see the next topic on the next class. Loga samasta sukhino bhavantu.